Hi, I'm Jason Brown with the Design for Repair team here at Microsoft. Today I will demonstrate the high-level disassembly steps and the repairability features in the new Surface Studio 2 Plus. For detailed repair instructions, see the service guide posted on the Microsoft support site. All repairs should be performed on an ESD work surface with grounding to protect the unit. Additionally, we recommend removing jewelry, like rings and watches, as well. Finally, it's important to use the Windows system to shut down the computer completely before any repair, and then ensure the power cable is disconnected from the device. First, let me orient you with the aspects of the device I will refer to throughout the demonstration. The 28-inch touchscreen assembly is referred to as the monitor. Next, we have the hinge, which easily adjusts the monitor to the working angle of your choice. And last, we have the base, which rests here on the table. The base is made up of a few different enclosures. The top cover is the T cover, the bottom cover is the C cover, and there's an internal cover we'll call the B cover. The tools required for disassembly include a driver with a T3, T6, T8, T10, and an H5 or 5mm socket. We'll also use a spudger and a couple pairs of ESD safe tweezers. Now let's get started. First, unplug the power cable from the wall, and then disconnect the cable from the base by sliding the plug away from the base to release the locking mechanism. Power must be disconnected from the device for at least 30 seconds before exposing any internal component. These steps are absolutely critical to avoid risk of personal injury, as this device contains an internal power supply with both AC and DC voltage. All repair operations occur with the display face down on a clean ESD safe surface. As the device weighs over 20 pounds and is somewhat awkward to move, please be mindful when placing the device into this position to avoid any personal injury or damage to the device. While I will reorient the device myself, you may consider finding another person to help with this step. To prepare for repair, I will place the monitor in the vertical position. Now, hold the device along the hinges at the midpoint, being mindful of pinch points near the monitor and the base. Slowly lift and rotate the device and lay it gently face down on the table. Now that we have the bottom of the base accessible, we will start by removing the C cover. I'll use a spudger to remove the 4 feet. Each foot is adhered within a small cavity, and so we'll push from the top down to release the foot. Now, using a T8 driver, remove the 4 screws, which were under the feet. Now we are ready to take off the C cover. There's a snap in the middle of the C cover, somewhat near the Microsoft logo. We're going to use a spudger to loosen the C cover a bit and undo the snap right there. There is also a bit of adhesive in here that we will need to pry off with a spudger. And finally, there's a few more snaps throughout the C cover, so you can just pull gently and the snaps will release. And we can remove the C cover. Now, we've exposed the B cover. And in the B cover, you can see a couple fans, a portion of the thermal module, and the power supply. To fully access these components and others, we do need to remove the B cover first. Again, using a T8 driver, we'll remove the following 8 screws. Note, I'm not going to remove the screws on the fans. We leave those intact. Okay, now when removing the B cover, note that there's a bit of foam tape near the fan, and that will come off. And then as we remove this, there's a few internal cables attached between the B cover and the base, so we want to be careful not to damage them. I'll pull out slightly on the B cover, and then I will rotate the B cover to about 45 degrees to expose the cables inside for disassembly. Now, using a pair of plastic tweezers, disconnect the connectors. The top connector is the speaker, then there's a small fan, and then the large fan. And now we can remove the B cover. The B cover also has the fans and the speaker, and I will come back to that and show you how to disassemble those. Now we have access to the full internals of the device. The first step here is to remove the thermal module. If you look closely at the gray components, you'll see the screws are numbered 1 through 8 for the assembly sequence. I will remove them in the reverse order for disassembly, starting with number 8. For screws 5 through 8, use a T8 driver. As you remove these, note that they are captive screws and will not fully come out of the device, but stay attached to the thermal module. Now for screws 1 through 4, use a T10 driver. Again, we'll do these in the reverse order. And finally, we will use an H5 socket to remove the standoff on the left side. I'll hold the thermal module while doing this, as this is the last fastener. There are a few thermal pads adhering the thermal module to various components. Gently rotate the thermal module to release the thermal interface material, and then remove the thermal module. Once the thermal interface material releases, you can gently remove the thermal module from the device. Now we will remove the RSSD. To do this, we will use a T3 driver, and we will have to lift up a bit on the thermal interface material covering the SSD to expose the screw. With the screw removed, you simply lift up to about 15 degrees and then slide the SSD out. To remove the power supply, we'll start with the AC connector inlet, and we will remove the standoff with an H5 socket. And after that, we will use the T8 driver to remove the opposing screw. Now we can remove the power plug port, and we'll need to deroute the cable using our spudger from the cable routing guard. Using the same T8 driver, remove the screw on top of the power supply, interfacing with the motherboard. Now, use your H5 socket and remove the standoff near the bottom of the power supply. We'll keep this close by as we're going to reinstall this soon. Use the standard tweezers to disconnect the small PSU cable towards the bottom while gently pulling out on the power supply. Once this connector is removed, rotate the power supply to about 45 degrees and reinstall the standoff to secure the motherboard while we remove the final connector. Now we can lay the power supply down to gain access to the larger connector, release the lock mechanism, and fully remove the connector. And now the power supply is out. Now remove the standoff using the H5 socket to avoid confusion during reassembly. Next, we will remove the motherboard using the T8 driver. We will remove the two screws securing the hinge covers first. Use a spudger to gently pry and release the adhesive under each of the covers. With the hinge covers removed, we can now disconnect the three display connectors, which are located near the hinge springs. To disconnect these, we'll have to unlock the lock bars from each using a spudger. Now disconnect the audio jack with the connector at the top. Note that you'll need to lift the white lock bar with the spudger prior to disconnecting this. Now we can remove the final three screws using the T8 driver again. To remove the motherboard, hold the motherboard along the edges and remove by first pulling slightly away from the enclosure and then rotating while moving down and away. We are now done with the base and we'll move on to disconnecting the monitor. Locate the H cover on the back of the device. The H cover is held on with snaps along the top edge and the bottom edge. So I'll use my hands to pry along the top edge to release the snaps, and then we'll rotate back to unlock the rear snaps. Just press gently and slightly pry, and now we can remove the hinge cover. Now, using a T6 driver, remove the two screws holding the black plastic piece. And now we can remove the same T6 fasteners holding each antenna on. There are three on each antenna. Again, using a T6 driver, remove the screw over the foil on each antenna board. And now we can use a spudger to gently remove the foil from each side. With the foils off, we can now remove the final two screws from the antenna boards using a T6 driver again. Align the antenna cables with the notch in the metal plate and then carefully remove the metal plate. Now we can disconnect the four display cables. Gently pull up on each cable. Now, using the T8 driver, we'll remove the final nine screws. First, we'll remove the three screws along the top edge, and then we'll remove the bottom six screws. Now, the hinge is a little bit loaded at this point, so what I'm going to do is slide this down so it's off the table to unload the spring. Make sure you're holding the hinge and supporting it when you remove these final fasteners. And now the hinge is fully disconnected from the monitor, and we can simply lift it away. And finally, let's go back and take the speaker and fans out of the base B cover. For the fans, using a T8 driver, remove the five screws. And now we can first remove the small fan. Careful with the cables so you don't damage it. Now we can remove the larger fan. And now we're going to flip this over and we will remove the speaker from the B cover. To deroute the speaker cable, use a spudger to open the rounding clip and gently pull the cable through with your hand. Now we'll remove the last two screws with our T8 driver. Now we can remove the speaker. That wraps up my demonstration. For complete repair instructions, refer to the steps detailed in the service guide I mentioned earlier. I hope you found the video useful. Please check out the Microsoft site for more information or to learn about Microsoft's sustainability efforts.